Hello everyone, this video how to create continuous delivery with Sitefinity in Azure App Services is part of how-to series about Sitefinity and Azure. In the previous videos we already deployed our Sitefinity website along with a database on Azure App Services. The next step is to create a continuous delivery pipeline and develop our application following the best guidelines. Before we go to the actual setup, I want to share with you one very simple infographic. Our continuous delivery and continuous integration processes should follow this workflow. The code goes from local to staging and after this to production, but the database has the opposite flow. To have its latest state, we have to get it from live and develop locally against it. Having all that in mind, we need to configure our local project to use a copy of the production database. We have two options. The first one is to duplicate the database instance in the Azure portal. Go to it, click copy, after this give it a name and click OK. Once it's created, get the newly generated connection string from the overview menu. The another option is to use the SQL Management Studio and export the DB from the Azure server and import it to your local instance. Click on the database and select Export Data Tire Application. Choose where to save it, click Next and Finish. After this, go to your local SQL server instance and import the DB by clicking the Import Data Tire Application. We are ready with the database setup and now have to create new instances of our Sitefinity web app for each environment from the continuous delivery pipeline. Azure is providing deployment slots functionality that allows us to create testing and staging environments under the hood of our production website. To have this option available when you create your app in the portal, you have to choose a plan that supports it. For example, standard or platinum. Let's go and see how this works. Select your deployment slots of your app, click add and give it a name. Think of the deployment slots as a copy of your production app residing under the production version. When you view it in the portal menu, it has the same functionalities like a standard Azure App Services application. To deploy your changes to that staging server, you have to download the publish profile and use it in the same manner as I showed it in the previous videos. Once the new version of your Sitefinity web app is deployed, you can look at it simply by opening the generated Azure URL. After you check that everything looks and works as expected, you can swap the staging instance with production with one click. The good news is that this option avoids downtime and a preliminary warm-up is already done. Azure automates the whole process with the slots by providing continuous delivery option to your app in the portal. It connects the Azure app to your repo, gets the code from there and builds it. All this happens in your Visual Studio Team Services account. In case that you want to have environment to make load tests, you have to choose the load test option. Create a staging environment and once the project is deployed, you can swap it with the production environment automatically. I already set up a sample project using this flow and let's look at it. The continuous delivery menu has the history and steps of our builds. Here my build definition and the different phases during the whole process. You can add different tasks before and after the build. Let's go back again to the Azure portal. When you commit a change to your repo, you can sync your application at any time and trigger the whole continuous delivery procedure. The last piece is to change the connection string for each environment. Click on the staging slot application settings and add the connection string that you want to use in this environment. In your local project, move the connection string from data config file to the web config file. One caveat here is that if your database is hosted on Azure, you have to add the backend value at the end of the connection string value. Also, the provider name should be System Data SQL Client. With this, we covered the basics of the continuous delivery with Sitefinity and Azure. If you are interested for more details about Sitefinity and Azure, please watch the rest of the videos from the playlist.